Those special brew glues. It's only about 160 a tin, so it's a bargain by any fucker's reckoning. It's a day spent on the street, sitting on my seat, asking, chasing, scoring, snoring, here and there I pick up a couple of quid and everything's sweet for a bit. Don't think about eating or living or being anywhere else but here, in the sun or in the rain, when the evening escapes me and the morning runs away. It's the perfect product for a perfect consumer. Cheap as chips and with a couple of wobbly eggs washed down, it even beats smack. So fuck all you who suck bottles of bud in shitty nightclubs at 3 quid ago, buying into a dream of a self-image that'll melt like snow and soak into the dirt and the mud. Like a down payment on a car. Scraping by in the minimum wage, my life in a cage, counting down the days till I next get paid. Watch the money come in, watch it roll out again straight away. Got to believe that everything'll be okay or go crazy. Whether it's working my ass off in a factory or serving beers and coffees to people much younger than me who spend money like it grows on trees, it's all a joke. So broke I haven't bought new clothes in years. Spend what little I have when it appears on booze and smoke to help me cope as the desperation grows. Round and round the jobs I go. Where I stop, nobody knows. Thinking, I'm better than this. Even when I'm pissing away my potential like it doesn't exist, my mind is a clenched fist. Punching the wall after crawling out of my pit because I've got to go out and earn it. The right to live. A chance to survive and keep my dreams alive for another week. Cause I'm up the fucking creek with the bills again. So I just smash my brains, flush them down the drain, just get fucking wrecked. Come out with daft shit like thank God the car tax, drugs and sex. Sometimes wish I didn't have to think. And watch myself as I sink, deeper into doubt and debt. Got nothing to look forward to except crawling into bed at the end of a shift, praying before I go to sleep something will come along and lift me out of the shit and make all the struggling worth it. But at the same time I have to accept that this is just the way it is. Thank you. They tried to make me go to rehab. I said, fuck it, I can do a couple of weeks off work. Right, this next one's for anyone who has a mobile phone. This is called Available On Demand. Watching a girl called Erica Yates as she masturbates on my mate's mobile phone. She's from Brandsome and on this bit you can really hear her moan and groan, he says as his face displays a twisted grin. If he looks any closer, he might fall in. As the screen blares pink, my heart begins to sink and I try and think of something witty to say. Faint disgust lingering as I catch a glimpse of fingers. Fingering. As my morals dissipate, want to look away but it's too late. I hate the way the world is available on demand, on a tiny screen in the palm of your hand. A young girl frigging herself off downloaded to entertain me, but it drains me. Makes me face up to the acceptability of the truly obscene. Images captured and sold. A cold snapshot look at ordinary people as they fuck and hit each other around the head with blunt objects. And then there's nothing left. Every aspect of our existence rendered in pixels as we take in our fill of all the plebs and dregs destroying themselves for a laugh. And as we reach the film's climax, I have to face the fact that a 10-minute segment of brutal truth is proof indeed that within our hand may lay the seed of perversion or salvation, or at least something that should matter. Then my mate turns to me and says, now that's what I call an happy slapper. Thank you. Great. Sounded a bit like John Prescott there, didn't I? I'm going to miss him. I'm going to miss him in the same way Han Solo misses Jabba the Hutt. And if you haven't seen Return of the Jedi, it's not a fucking lot.
Sorry.
This next one's called Two Coppers in a Subaru. Two coppers in a Subaru, looking like Shaggy and Scooby-Doo in the Mystery Machine, winding down the window, one of them asks,
where you going, son? Where you been?
I'm just walking the street, watching my feet without a care. I ain't even got any bus fare. And what of all the money that's been spent on this fine-ass car, aren't you just ripping off the taxpayer? Shouldn't you be asking someone to give a decent chase for you, like a boy racer, charging down Spring Bank 100 miles an hour, £1,000 sound system in a £200 Nova? They both laugh like pricks in a way that makes me sick to my stomach. Nope, you're wasting your time, I continue. Swear down, I ain't committed a crime in years, since back when I was a kid, and I got caught doing some petty vandalism for kicks. And you know what? I'd have got away with it too if it weren't for you pesky pigs. Thank you. I rock it like a diva on the microphone. Imagine what I'll do to you at home. Not a lot, actually.
Probably have a few beers and pass out in front of the telly. Kind of guy I am.